So before we go out, what's your address?
I'm your national anthem.
Shopping with my bestie, we picked out books accessories for each other in 5 categories. Here we go. Book with first letter of their name. Book in their favorite color. Book we've been wanting the other to read. I messed up. I picked a book she's been wanting to read.
Okay.
A random choice. Accessory from a favorite fandom. She's my Monica. I'm her Rachel.
Today, I went book shopping in what I think is the coolest Barnes & Noble in the entire world, so I just have to show you. So this Barnes & Noble set up inside what once was an old movie theater that was built for Fox Studios back in 1938. I came here looking for one book, so I'm trying my hardest to stay focused. They have a section devoted to LGBTQ lit, so here are some of the queer books that I highly recommend you all check out. They also have this really cute beignet food truck out front, and then I bought two books instead of one.
There's nothing in between, and in my eyes there is a tiny dancer.
Weep for yourself, my man, you'll never be what is in your heart. Weep, little lion man, you're not as brave as you were at the start. Rate yourself and rake yourself, take all the courage you have. Wasted on fixing all the problems that you made in-
Shop at half-priced books with me. Off-one. Hi, bad boy. Comfort series. I heard these both were good. I need the two other books still. OMG, so many good books. Heard this was good. Harry Potter. I couldn't get into this book. Oh.
Have you ever thought about this? Someone told me that bookstores are dying and I didn't believe them, but it's true. My favorite used bookstore is closing because they can't afford to stay open, and it makes me wonder if one day all of them will. So I bought some books, I got myself my favorite feel-good snack, and I sat outside to read. I don't want to live in a world without books, so please keep reading and support bookstores.
My best friend and I have a tradition where we go book shopping every time I go home to visit, so I'm gonna take you with us. The morning started off by Heather picking me up, saying, "Get in, loser, we're going book shopping." And we headed straight to our favorite brunch place and, of course, had to get some drinks to blame our book-buying tendencies on. But we got our breakfast, which was so delicious, and then we headed straight to our favorite independent bookstore called Main Street Books, which is on Main Street in St. Charles, and it is the cutest little bookstore. But if you go upstairs, they house my favorite section, which is the YA section. And, of course, we had to stop and look at these ugly new ACOTAR covers in the wild. Yikes. But we secured our purchases and headed to our second stop, which is Half Price Books, which is my absolute favorite used bookstore and how I can get so many hardcovers for cheap. Usually when we come here, we head straight towards the back to the teens fiction section, but I did stop and find an annotated copy of Final Girls by Riley Sager himself, so I knew I had to get it. So I tossed that in our basket and we made our purchases, and then here's my final book haul, and Heather ended up buying half the store. But that's it, bye.